Hello, and welcome to another Ask Excite. I'm Tim Bushnell with Expert Cytometry, and today's question comes from Monica, who asks, what is the best way to exclude dead cells? Excellent question, Monica. Very important one. Dead cells confound our analysis because they mask as positive cells because they can non-specifically take up all the antibodies in our panel. So to exclude them, we want to use something that's going to separate and take advantage of the fact that the dead cells tend to have a compromised membrane. So if you're going to be looking at live cells, if you're going to be doing a cell sorting experiment, or you're just analyzing your cells after you stain them, you can use a cell impermeant dye. Things like DAPI, 7-AAD, ToPro3, propidium iodide. All these work by binding to DNA and can only get into the cell when it's compromised. Now, if you're looking at intracellular targets, say a FOXP3 or other intracellular antigen that you're interested in, what you're going to need to use is something like an amine reactive dye. These dyes are antibodies that bind to the amine group of proteins, and there's not a lot on the surface of the cell, so they'll have a dim expression. Intracellularly, there'll be much more amine reactive groups, so you'll see a much higher expression. You stain your cells with amine reactive dyes, then stain them with your antibodies, and then you'll be able to determine positive and from negative based upon that amine reactive dye. Whatever you do, please design your panel and add a viability dye. It really improves the quality of your data. Thanks for the question, Monica. And remember, if you have more questions, go to getflowtraining.com for more information. And if you want your question answered here, send it to askexcite@expertcytometry.com. Thanks for another Ask Excite. Until next time, be sure to keep up with your flow cytometry best practices right here with your friends in flow, Tim and Team Excite.